Attempting to tell you what were my favorite books for each month of the year so far. I have a feeling this is gonna be so hard. And yes, I could have waited for the end of the year to actually do this, but I just felt like doing it right now. So for January, this is already so hard. I'm really struggling to choose between A Thousand Ships, Piranesi, and Know My Name. But I think Piranesi wins. I think it wins just because of the reading experience in itself. It was such a unique story to read that I think that one's gonna win. So January, Piranesi. February is surprisingly easy. I'm going to say Lonely Castle in the Mirror. I feel like most people that have been following my account will know that I absolutely love this book, so I have to say Lonely Castle in the Mirror. March is quite hard because I didn't really read that many books. One of them was a reread and the other two are just not that great. So I guess I'm gonna go with A Little Life, even though this was a reread for me. This is way easier than I thought it was going to be. For April, I'm going to say Hemnet by Maggie O'Farrell. That's one of the most beautifully written books I have ever read in my life. Okay, for May, the plot has thickened because it got a lot harder. I have to choose between Transcendent Kingdom, Finding Me, and Kai Kei. Oh, this sucks. I'm gonna go with Finding Me by Viola Davis. I just can't not do that. June, I'm going to go with The Island of Missing Trees. I absolutely adore this book. And if you're into like nature kind of stories, read this. It's beautiful. It's very unique as well. For July, I'm going to go with Station 11 because this book made me feel so proud of being human. And that's not usually a feeling I often feel. August is absolutely not going to make me pick between My Dark Vanessa, Babel, and Tomorrow and Tomorrow and Tomorrow. I can't do that. I can't. They're all so different too. How can I do that? How can I pick one? Oh my god, I feel like this is like my Sophia's choice. Okay, I'm not gonna go with My Dark Vanessa. It's between Babel and Tomorrow and Tomorrow and Tomorrow. I have to go with Babel. I'm so sorry to Tomorrow and Tomorrow and Tomorrow. What comes after August? September. For September, I'm gonna go with Severance by Ling Ma. If you liked Beautiful World, Where Are You? And Station 11, if those two books had a baby, it would be Severance, so check it out. For October, I have to choose between Bear Town, Legendborn, and The Weight of Blood. I gave all of these books 5 stars. Why do I have to do this? I actually don't have to do this. That's the thing. I want to do this, so I have to stop being a little baby about it. Bear Town. I'm so sorry to the other two. I'm gonna go with Bear Town. November, I have to go with My Girl Brie. It's gonna be Bloodmarked, even though Thistlefoot deserves an honorable mention. This was so freaking hard. I hope this wasn't too chaotic and was somewhat entertaining, but let me know in the comments what are the best books that you've read in 2022.
This is my 2022 BookTok year in review. A book that made me cry. A book that made me happy. A book that pleasantly surprised me. A book that I read in a day, a book that I think more people should read, a book that I cannot stop recommending, a book that I can't stop thinking about, and my favorite book that I read this year. Oh, I don't wanna.
Here's all the books I want to read before the end of the year. The first one is The Secret Santa. I'm so excited to read this one. It is a Christmas read, but it is a thriller. The thrills I've read so far in December that are Christmas themed have been amazing, so I'm excited for this one. Got another Christmas book, Surrounding for Christmas by Sarah Morgan. I was kindly gifted this by Milton Boone, and definitely one that I need to read before Christmas. And the last Christmas book on my list for the end of the year is The Christmas Bookshop. This just sounds so, so sweet. It's less like romantic or thriller themed and more of like a contemporary book. I'm so excited to read this. So I definitely want to read this one for the end of the year as well. I picked it up from a charity shop a couple of weeks ago, but it's very like Silent Patient vibes, Gone Girl vibes, so I'm excited to give it a read. And the final book on my list for the end of the year is The Guest List by Lucy Foley. This has been on my TBR for forever, and I love The Paris Apartment, so I don't know why I still haven't got to this. So these are the five books I want to read for the end of the year. Let me know what yours are.